had some of the now uses of fund, because we're looking at the sources of fund. Now we're looking at some of the uses of fund. We'll be looking at the Mawabaha and BBA and Mushara Kamutanathisa, Parallel and Sisna, and then of course at the Wabi in terms of home financing. Now, the first thing I'll ask you here is, what's the difference between Mawabaha and BBA? Huh? What does BBA stand for?
Al-Bayn,
Bitamanin, Ajil. Deferred payment. Okay, what about Mawabaha?
Cost plus pricing.
Cost plus plus. Now you see this word, Al-Bayn Bithamanin Ajil, essentially, listen carefully, essentially it is not a contract. Are you with me? Al-Bayn Bithamanin Ajil in principle is not a contract, because you can buy and pay, or you can make a purchase on profit and still pay by installment. You can buy at loss, still pay by installment. You can buy at cost price, but still pay by installment. So essentially, Al-Bayn Bithamanin Ajil is not supposed to be a separate contract. Are you with me? Now, you must differentiate between a product and a contract. A product and a contract. The contract is called al-murabaha. Al-murabaha normally is, like you rightly pointed out, when it's a cost plus. You sell something with a cost and a profit. And in your mu'amalat, you have learned the condition of al-murabaha. One of the important conditions is you have to disclose the cost price and also disclose the profit margin. But the market as an urf, as a custom, they separated between al-murabaha and al-bay bithamanin ajil as a market practice. But the principle underlying BBA is al-murabaha. You get what I'm trying to say? The underlying contract is al-murabaha. But the market differentiated it and call it BBA. So in the Southeast Asian market, particularly Malaysia, Indonesia, and Singapore, and a few others, they use BBA for long-term financing. Long-term. So when we talk about long-term, we are talking about more than 1 year to 25 to 30 years. And they use al-murabaha for what? Short-term. So short-term means between? 6 months to 1 year. 6 months, 1 year is called short-term. They use al-murabaha. Since this is a long-term, they use it to finance assets plus equipment, because this requires long-term financing. And this for a short term, they use it for working capital. Are you with me? So one is short term, long term, working capital. Is it for asset? So here, payment is in lump sum Or sometimes by installment. But here mostly payment is by what?
Installment.
Yes. Payment is by installment. Okay, so the moment you hear BBA, this is long term, and then this is a short term. Mm-hmm. And then we'll be looking at parallel, this is now and tomorrow. So among the uses of funds, we'll be looking at the financing murabaha and fifth murabaha, some applications of murabaha, BBA home financing, and then murabaha to the purchase order, issues, and then musharaka with an artisan. So when you look at the use of funds, we find in retail financing, funds are used for home financing, automobile financing, and then personal financing. And usually for automobile, we'll be looking at a Mijar, Fumba and Bay, ITEP. And then of course personal financing, mostly they use Tawaro. And then corporate financing, we have term financing, trade financing, and working capital. Trade financing mostly in the form of letter of credits. Letter of credits. So let's look at this fifth murabaha. The murabaha that you read in fifth, they normally involve two parties. Meaning that a seller and a buyer. And the markup and cost prices are normally disclosed. And the third one is very important. Pricing is on the asset side or based on cost of product. This is very fundamental for you. What do you mean asset side? Do you do accounting? Right. If you have your balance sheet, where's the asset?
Left side.
This side, this side. This is a liability, yeah? And then liability and equity on this side. Okay. Now, we say that the fifth murabaha, they price the asset, they price it on the asset side, the pricing. Meaning that they look at the real cost of the asset. Are you with me? If this table belongs to me, where will I record the table? On the asset side, are you with me? On the asset side, because it belongs to me, it's an ownership. So all my prices, it belongs to me, it will be on this asset side. But the banking murabaha that we use, they don't price on the asset side, they price on the liability side. Okay, how does that happen? Okay. A simple example is, if I am going to use, let's say, ijara. Ijara is what?
Lease.
Before I lease something to you, I must own what?
Own
the asset, right? Yes. If I'm going to lease a car to you, the car must be mine. And where do I record the car?
Asset side.
Asset side, okay? So you'll be renting and then it's easier. My pricing will always be on the asset side. But the bank, they don't record their assets on the asset side. Okay? So if the bank wants to rent a car to you, the bank doesn't own the car. It goes to a company to own the car, then it gives financing through the company. When it gives financing through the company, It is no longer an asset, it's a liability. Are you following what I'm trying to say? So what the bank is pricing is not the car, it's pricing the cost of the money it's giving to you. Huh? The company is doing the job, but the bank is not concerned with the car. The bank is concerned with the amount of money it is using to finance the car. So in other words, the prices of banks are usually on the liability side, not on the asset side of the balance sheet. That is why banks are always concerned about cost of capital. Not the cost of the car, not the cost of the house, the cost of the capital. Are you with me? Now, the older field, they don't care about your cost of your capital. They care about what? Pricing of the asset. That is why when you study those field and you want to apply it in the bank, it's not just like a Sharia board will say, this Shafi say this. No, it doesn't work this way. Because those guys live in a different generation. They did not live in the banking generation. So sometimes we make to them claim which they did not make. Are you with me? For example, Al-Imam al-Shafi and other a'imma, they will say, if you pay on cash, pay this much. If you pay by installment, increase this much. Are you with me? Be careful. They say in Bel Ma'adum, you can pay this much for cash, and if you want to defer, you pay this much. Are you with me? Okay. Is it true that this statement of Shafi'i means I get a house and you factor this house, you price this house based on time factor and all this? Do you think a Shafi'i knows about your time factor?
Time factor, is it time value of money?
Exactly. Does Shafi'i know about your calculation of LIBOR and all this? Huh? Shafi'i never existed in LIBOR. Huh? Suddenly say, LIBOR is halal because Shafi'i said. No, Shafi'i never say LIBOR. Isn't it? Malik never say LIBOR.
So why does it mean? I mean, if you are deferring the payment, you can pay.
Exactly. So they mean the real asset. Okay? They are talking to you about table, talking to you about car. Mm-hmm. They have no idea of your, using time value. It's not in their book. So if you say they say this, you are misrepresenting what they say because they never said it. Are you with me? They never said it. So when we interpret them, we should interpret them correctly.
Maybe they also took into consideration the time, like the.
Okay, but this time in relation to what?
Assets.
Not time in relation to money, no. When we are giving you a house loan, we are not saying, your house, we don't calculate your house. How many years you want to borrow? 10 years. Or 10 years. How many? 15? They don't say your house. I don't think Shafi brings the calculator. How many? 5? No, Shafi doesn't do that. Are you with me? So this is very, very important on the pricing. Later we'll see this pricing. So the financing murabaha, is it financing or trading? There's a very interesting case I will send to you, and I want you to read that case. It happened in Malaysia. It was quite fatal on BBA. I just today forgot. It is in my computer. I will send it to you to read. Then in the next class we discuss. And I had a problem with the appeal court, one guy who was defending Bank Islam, because I gave an interview in Malaysian Reserve, and I supported the other. So this guy, it almost became like academic fighting with me, the banker, the lawyer. So okay, so I will send you that article for you to read. So Is it a lien or a dain, which we discussed earlier? Now, some of the applications of al-murabaha are, this you will do it with who? With Dr. Maya. We'll be discussing on an interesting case of al-murabaha as a sukuk. What are the contention? On consumer credit, working capital, town financing, we'll see inshallah if some of this we can cover. And then home financing, which we are trying to look at now. Now, look at this. Now again, I repeat to you, if you look at our diagram in theory, they're excellent. No Muslim in theory will say murabaha is haram. No Muslim will say this. If you say you're in trouble, you cannot say musharaka is haram. Our problem is not the theory of murabaha. Our problem is not the theory of musharaka. Our problem is what? The practice of murabaha. Please, you have differentiate it. Sometimes you go to the seminar. How they say murabaha is haram? Look at what Shafi say about murabaha. Look at what Ahmad. We have no problem with that. Why do you have to make it an issue? We don't have an issue with that. Sometimes in the seminar they'll show some of these finance, some of this. They reject our murabaha. Look at what Shafi says. Murabaha is, we have no problem with Shafi. We have no problem with Malik. But show us your practice. That's why we have a problem. We have no problem with the theory. Are you with me? So if you look at practice, this is what normally happens. I'm giving you the practice, not the theory. So in practice, you have property developer. So these guys normally, they have their advertisement in shopping center. Nowadays online, they can advertise the property. And when you go to this big shopping complex, you find, oh, they put a showcase. Come on in, go back now, we are building, okay, you look. So they show you prototype, very nice, this developed, okay? Now when you are interested, you have to either pay booking fee to them, and if your interest is more, then you pay what? Deposit. Are you with me? This is very important. When you pay deposit, where is the house? Where's the house? Not there. The house is under what? Under construction. Are you with me? In the hadith we say, ma'adum. It's not there. Are you with me? The house is not there. So, you pay deposit. Now we come up with our banking structure, Islamic banking. Or we pay deposit and then we say, the house is not there. We say, the developer sells to us beneficial ownership. Are you with me? Do you know the concept of beneficial ownership? You heard about beneficial ownership? Okay, beneficial ownership is a word derived from the common law of trust. Law of trust is a common law. It is not a fiqh. You don't find that definition in fiqh. In fiqh, ownership is either complete or incomplete. Okay, they call it milkiya tamma. Or milkiya naqisa. When you have a car, you own the car and also you use the car, we said you are owning complete ownership. What it means? The asset plus the usufruct, the benefits of the assets. So in other words, what you have is ownership of usufruct and ownership of assets in fiqh. There is no beneficial ownership. So the common law, the British law, they have divided ownership into legal and then beneficial. Are you with me? Legal means it gives title to the bank to have the right on the property. When you go to court, the court doesn't look at you because legally you are not the owner, you only own beneficial ownership. The person who owns legally is the bank. Do you get my point? In Saudi Arabia, they have a different structure. Instead of the bank, it's the shareholders that have the legal ownership. You go to buy the house is in the name of what? Shareholder. There's a case which is taking around almost 7 years. Why? Because the customer died, and the children want to go and claim the house of the father. But the court says, no, 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 your father doesn't own. It is this shareholder man who owns the house. You understand? Because he has legal ownership.
So the house cannot transfer to another generation?
Cannot. Beneficial ownership cannot. You can only transfer what? Legal title. After you finish what?
The payment.
You finish the payment, then the bank says, okay, I have the legal title. If you do any hanky-panky, you lose the house because the bank has the legal ground. You don't have any legal ground. There are more than 350 cases of abandoned houses. You go to Muslim Consumer Association. Are you with me? Many houses which involves BBA. And I'll be sharing some of those cases with you. But the name will be closed, not disclosed, because they will charge me for secret work. Something called secret work, Yes. Okay. Now, are you with me? So when you pay deposit, they give you what?
Beneficial
ownership. They say now you have beneficial ownership. Okay? Now you enter into a contract with the bank. But in my diagram, I show as if it's a step. But during your buying, believe me, everybody's there, the signature, all the documents are just signed there. But it looks pretty nice, like, oh, you go to the bank. No, it doesn't work this way. All the papers are just, all the agents are there. You just sign. Even one agent will be enough. Oh, which bank? Okay. Wait. Bring the form of the bank down. Sign. Everything is signed, okay? Are you with me? But for your study, I will put a diagram so that you know how the direction moves. But all the same, okay? So you see, the bank and the customer, they enter into a contract called Property Purchase Agreement and Property Sale Agreement. Remember, the customer paid 10%, and then the house is supposed, and please open your ears and eyes. What does the customer own? Beneficial ownership. Are you with me? Now see the interesting thing. Suddenly the customer is selling to the bank. You know what the customer is selling? Customer is selling a house to the bank. Okay? And the bank is selling back the house. But where's the house?
Yeah, where? Manufacturing. Still not manufacturer.
And yet, after selling the house, the customer still owns beneficial ownership. I'm confused already. And sell the house, buy the house.
Sell the house.
Okay? That is in theory what they say. But in practice, when you sign the form, you don't sign like that. The form is already standard. Standard form you sign is already standard. Beneficial ownership. Are you with me? So now this here, sell and buy back. What do you call it? Ina. Ina sale. Sale and buyback is like in a sale. Okay? Once you have this in a sale, What happened? Then the bank provides the financing to the
customer,
the developer. So then you keep on paying the installment. But now they say, you know, this BBA has brought a lot of problems. We change it to tawarruk. Yeah. Much of the funding is tawarruk. And we saw the tawarruk right. You come to the bank and say, bank, I want to buy a house. The bank says, okay, I will sell to you palm oil. You want a house, but the bank will sell to you palm oil. So go some, exactly. So that's okay, we buy palm oil, I sell to you on deferment. How many? 15 years. Then you have to sell back to the bank in cash at a lower price. Okay? So your contract is commodity, marabaha, palm oil, but the financing goes to the house. You get the point? Yeah. So there's a discrepancies. Discrepancies in the way using this tawarruk. All this is because, you know, we are compelled by the conventional rules and regulations. Because these conventional rules and regulations, the banking rules, do not allow our banks to own. Because banks are there for financing. So for you to behave like a bank, you have to fine tune it. And you need to have smarter Sharia scholars. I don't know how smart they are. Huh? They can turn a curve where the car will not fall, but turn the corners. Huh? A lot of corners. I mean, a lot of corners. So this is called BBA. Huh? And you know, I tell you one reality. We went to Sri Lanka. And if you get time, maybe you'll ask Dr. Sulajastri. He was one of the speakers. The former DG of IRTI was one of the speakers. We were three of us. We went for training in Sri Lanka. So in the aeroplane, I told my colleagues, I said, you see, let us be sincere and realistic. And Allah will give us power. We know our current Islamic banking has a lot of, you know, faults in it. It is not perfect. So if we go to our audience, let us be frank to them and say, you see, because of our constraints, our banking is not perfect. But we are moving towards ideal. And we tell them that this is the problem with our system now, but this is the ideal in which we are moving to. Then at least people will appreciate that we are sincerely telling what's happening and this is where we are moving. But one of the speakers said, no, you know, we cannot sell it that way. We have to sell and make it Islamic. And I said, okay, then you become the first speaker. I'll listen, I'll see how successful you sell it. Okay? And believe me, this brother went and presented this, something like this. One central banker from the Sri Lanka Central Bank. He came with, as if he came prepared, subhanAllah, they came with the same diagram. He put the conventional on one side and put the Islamic and said, convince me that the two are different. Are you with me? It was really tough. Convince me that the two are different. And you could see our speaker really sweating because it's really tough to tell this different. Huh? So we saw that the situation was already going out of hand. So we decided both of us to come and intervene and go to plan A, the early plan. As we tell them that, yes, you are right, brother, because these are some of the flaws and because of the conventional thing, we hope to correct A, to correct B, to correct C, we need this. Then they started appreciating. So my point also to you here is that if you present, there are certain things you cannot defend. it cannot be defended. The best you could say is just to admit that there are shortcomings. And these shortcomings, we have to work hard to overcome that. Are you with me? Yes, so this is very, very fundamental, especially the new generation. Know that they may have their reasons why they want to have the goods launched in the market. We don't doubt their sincerity. Maybe they want to work for Islam. They were in a hurry to launch Islamic finance. We appreciate that. But at this level in which we are in now, we need to have a different mode of moving the market forward. You cannot have the same argument. Oh, you know, we are still new. You know, we are still in Darura. You know, this argument people don't buy now. You mean for 50 years we are still in Darura? Huh? Cannot be. So we have to be moving forward. Are you with me? Now, these are some of the issues raised about the banks. Although the market propagates the idea that BBA home financing is based on trade, in reality it is what? Financing, because bank customers identify the property, bank customers negotiate the price, and bank merely provides financing. Stringent provisions in many Muslim countries actually prohibit banks from engaging in actual trading. Now, here is again, look at this. This is how we compute our BBA calculation. I think you don't have it there, you have to. Because I put you a wrong slide, because I have so many of these slides. So when I check, I did Allah, I put an old one. This should be the new one, so you update this one. Now you see, do we know annuity factor? What's annuity factor?